U.S.-based funds and their investors face significant changes as the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission prepares to implement its liquidity management rules. These rules stand to have a significant impact on the industry. And recently, I caught up with ICI Counsel Matt Thornton to learn what the ICI has asked of the SEC and how we're assisting members in responding.
Well, because it's so important to the industry, we've continued our engagement with the SEC even though the rule has been adopted. There's much in the rule we like and absolutely believe should go forward. However, in the July letter to Chairman Clayton, we point out that the bucketing requirements in particular are going to be a real challenge for the industry and not really add much to fund managers' understanding of liquidity or risk generally. But in the same letter, we recommend that while the SEC is re-examining the bucketing, you know, let's put a delay in place, let the industry press pause at least on that aspect of the rule, keep working towards compliance with the rest so that when the time comes, we have a workable rule that really does do what the SEC set out. And we also point out in the letter that even if they don't reopen the rule, the industry is going to need a delay because as it stands now, there's no simple turnkey solution that lets funds bucket in the rule compliant way. And that's creating a real bottleneck to the implementation process.
So Matt, considering the size of this task, how is ICI helping its members respond to this?
Well, it's certainly the SEC engagement. We've submitted the letter and we'll continue to work with the staff in ways to clarify the rule and make it more workable. But at the same time, you know, we are working with members towards implementation on the current very aggressive timeline that the SEC has put in place. So that's included things like in-person liquidity working group meetings, frequent calls, usually one or two a month. We've dealt with the issue at every conference since the rule was adopted. We've done a webinar. And all the information is pulled together on our resource page for members.